Parmalee on 102.9 W4 Country. Take my name. Good morning. It's 7:40 with Bubba and Madison in the morning.
Good morning.
Brian Welch has the forecast.
Rainy with highs just in the mid-40s.
Not liking that. It is a Monday. That means we have Dr. Marty here for your Monday morning jumpstart. Good morning.
Good morning.
Have a good weekend?
I had a good weekend.
What'd you do?
Well, we had it's my daughter's birthday week and a half, I guess.
Hold on, it's your birthday week too.
Yeah.
I know, but she outshines me on that though. She was born 2 days after me, so we went out again and had sushi with my brother-in-law and his family.
Well, that's nice.
Nice.
Are you a real sushi guy or are you a California roll guy?
I am a real sushi man.
I am not. I'm like California roll and shrimp tempura roll.
No raw fish for you?
Just not a fan.
You don't like oysters either, do you?
No.
Oh, come on.
I tell you what, Cody and Tyler at the Fillmore.
Oh yeah.
They're so proud of their oysters there. They've got a huge selection of oysters.
That's where I get them usually.
And every time I go in the Fillmore, someone wants me to try this variety of oyster and that variety of oyster, and it's Welch, you said it best, and I think it's a comedian that originally coined it.
What was it? That's Jim Gaffigan, snot from a rock.
It's like a booger in a shell. I can't do it. I just can't do it. It's a texture thing. What are we talking about on the Monday morning jumpstart, Miss?
We're gonna talk about humility and why humility matters. Do you know what humility is, anybody? You have a definition?
I think I'm pretty aware of what humility is.
By contrast?
If you would like to join us, we are online right now at W4TV at facebook.com/W4Country, youtube.com/W4Country. We'll see you there. We'll talk about humility next, your Monday morning jumpstart. It's 102.9 W4 Country. I'm at two. We're all on two. The music is not on two, which is good.
We got it.
That is good.
Hey, it's working out today.
Oh boy, we have lots of people saying things already.
Good morning.
James Payne, good morning.
Good morning, James.
Hey, Kyle. We celebrate birthdays this weekend. October's a busy month.
I think that's real because like, Kathy just said that. She's like, man, so many birthdays in October.
I haven't been invited to a birthday party.
Mm-hmm. Neither have I. Just the family.
Are these Valentine's babies? Does that make sense then?
Mm-hmm. Maybe it's just like there's a mating cycle for humans, like does, like deer.
This is a January board in winter.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's dead of winter. Mm-hmm. What else are we going to do?
Yep.
Yeah.
But deliver babies.
Manufacture
them. You begin the process, if you will.
That's a 9-month process.
Puppy. Pamela, what kind of puppy?
Everybody I know is getting puppies.
Why is that? Why do you think? They're great.
I don't know.
If you can do it, I recommend it.
Stacy.
Good morning.
I'll say things too.
Getting involved, good.
Just getting involved, well, good. That's what you're saying. Or is there a bigger reveal coming? She is a Vizsla. I'm not sure I know what that is. I'm gonna have to look that up.
I'm sure I don't know.
Made up.
Right.
I don't believe you.
Aw.
What
looks a little like a kind of like a Weimaraner,
yeah,
but brown.
I like the dogs with the serious faces, like Fletch has a really serious face, it looks good in pictures.
McKenna has the best judgmental face, she always looks like she's judging me in pictures.
Looks like.
Yeah, she's always judging.
Rightfully so. Oh my gosh, lots of stuff. Trying to send a picture. Oh, can you send pictures through this?
I don't know. It's a good question.
Huh. And then we'll share it on the screen.
I don't know if you can do that.
Julie, my brother has two.
Guess we'll find out.
Whoa, now.
Two what?
Vislas.
Two what?
Are you part of this conversation?
Well, I am. Vislas. I don't know if she was talking about dogs
or just puppies. We don't know.
I have no idea. Right.
This is a good comment if you want to read it.
Why do we have such a hard time accepting?
Well, I think
we're good enough.
Okay.
Maybe kind of productive here, but it is A-C-C-E-P-T.
Oh, will you stop correcting?
For reasons like that.
I think, because I've thought about it a lot, because my patients, I'm thinking that some of them, most of them are just wonderful, wonderful people. You know, kind, gentle, don't hurt anyone, sometimes themselves, but... And I think it's humility. That's where the lack of humility is, where the pressure is coming from, is what I think. Because it's difficult to be. Look at social media. I mean, someone thinks if they have a thought, it must certainly be true, and your thought is certainly not true. And, you know, and they'll tell you that oftentimes arrogantly. You know.
Stand by. .9 W4 Country. I hope you had a great weekend. I had a wonderful weekend. I was in Lubbock, Texas, getting to know Captain Dean Cott of Munith. I want to say good morning to him. He's woken up.
He woke up.
He woke up early.
He's now awake.
And there was awakening.
It was an awakening. An awakening. I'm sure this weekend was an awakening for Dean.
Afterwards.
Yeah. But he is in Clovis, New Mexico, and he drove to Lubbock, so I didn't have to visit Clovis.
I see.
Thank you, Dean. Mm-hmm. Much appreciated.
Okay.
Not that I don't ever want to see Clovis. It's just not on my top 800 list. This morning, we are talking about humility. We have Dr. Marty here. We want to make your Monday better with your Monday morning jump start. And what is humility, Marty?
That's a great question. Humility is, it really is about self-acceptance. It's the ability to view ourselves, you know, all of our talents, all of our flaws, and still accept ourselves. I think what it does is it takes a lot of pressure off of us if we can just accept ourselves in spite of those things, in spite of the imperfections and the mistakes that we make. So it's not low self-esteem, because we still, we don't judge ourselves.
Like, I feel that accepting stuff about me actually makes me more confident. Does that make sense?
It makes perfect sense. That's what it is. And not only that, but it motivates us to change. That's counterintuitive. But what happens when we take the pressure off and realize, hey, I'm going to have to develop this slowly. I'm not good at it right now. And the pressure's off because, what the heck? I'll give it a shot, right?
Very cool. I'm sure you got a top five list. Let's dive in. Is this how to improve humility? How to know you're humble? What is it?
Well, we'll talk about both, but this is really about the value of it. What you get out of it.
What's point number one?
Well, it proves that we don't know it all. And okay, everybody will say, oh, I know I don't know everything. But then why do you behave? Or why do we behave sometimes like we do know everything? So it also, and that inspires curiosity more, because if I don't know everything, I might search to know more. And,
I never thought I knew it all for anything.
Yeah, but you've never
behaved. Well, it's not global all the time. It's situational sometimes.
Well, those people in pre-check on Friday, I acted like a know-it-all with them.
Yeah. Okay.
Know what you're doing before you get in the stupid pre-check line.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Don't take off your shoes.
There, it's demonstrated.
Yeah.
In vivo.
What's point number two, Marty?
Point number two, it allows us to see beyond ourselves. When our world gets small and our view of ourselves and others shrinks, we don't like that very much. Humility will let us see beyond ourselves, and that's kind of kills our ego a little bit, which is really a good idea.
All right, more with Dr. Marty coming up. 7:49 is the time. Let's get to the Brighton Ford Traffic Center right now and find out what's going on.
We have some heavier traffic to report. Let's start with 94 westbound, starting just past Michigan Avenue, continuing all the way to State. You're going to see some heavier and maybe even slower moving traffic. We have some heavier traffic on US 12 right around 23 and on Michigan Avenue around downtown Saline. It looks like there's an accident to report on Michigan Avenue right in the middle of downtown. We'll keep an eye on that. We do have heavier traffic on 23 northbound right around US 12, right around 94. And then on the southbound side, we're looking at slower traffic from 96 all the way down to about 9 Mile Road. We also have heavier traffic on 96 eastbound just ahead of 23. And then again, by the construction, through the construction by Pleasant Valley all the way through Kent Lake Road. We have heavier traffic through the construction on 275 as well. That's right around 12, right around 94. And then on mostly the northbound side between Ford Road all the way up through 96. A little heavier on M14, right around Ford Road on the westbound side and on the eastbound side from Barton to 23. If you have a tip for us, 734-623-1029. That's the latest from the only station specializing in your local traffic, 102.9 W4 Country.
Rain in the forecast again today. What shape is your roof in? Do you know? Get a hands-on estimate from Diversified Roofing. They are the folks who replaced my roof, and I needed a new one. It was rotted or bats in it. I had no idea until I got someone on it, and they gave me a warranty that will last longer than I will. Those shingles are warranted for 50 years on my roof. Get Diversified Roofing and their hands-on estimate to work for you. Go to DiversifiedRoofingLLC.com. That's DiversifiedRoofingLLC.com.
This report is sponsored by KFC. Presented by Kentucky Fried Chicken, $6 two-piece drum.
Man, KFC sounds good right now.
I was just going to talk about that. Like, how good is KFC? You got to
admit. I haven't had it in, I don't know how long. Years. Yeah, years, probably.
But isn't it good?
Oh, yeah.
It's terrible. It is good. Sure,
famous good. Bowls are the best.
What do you like?
Just put everything in a bowl, right?
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Blah, blah, blah.
Who's this guy?
Some humble creature. I think he's being sarcastic.
Did we get rid of Tony?
We can kick him out.
Yeah, kick him out.
No, I think he's joking.
Is he joking?
I think so. You'd have to, you have to be really... You'd have to be really unaware of yourself to.
Why are you putting it back up again?
Because I wanted to let people know why we were going to kick him out if we're going to kick him out.
Tony, if that is your name,
let's
first name only, no picture.
Right.
Yeah.
I'm not buying it.
300 pounds sent in your parents' basement. My guess.
Wait, he might be a nice guy making a joke.
Fire this morning.
I'm fired up today.
Don't kick me out. I'll report the channel.
Oh no.
Well, kick him out.
Tony, guess what you're doing to yourself.
Yeah.
Bye.
Bye.
I put him in timeout. We'll see what happens.
Like, people don't understand. Like, social media channels, like, my everything is my everything. I can curate it how I want. Just because you have a voice doesn't mean you get one.
Right. But I'm just, this is kind of proving my point. Like, you about, you know, our lack of, me, too. I mean, I'm not being self-righteous about this. It's hard in our culture, I think, you know, we elevate people, you know, that, you know, and kind of idolize them almost, you know what I mean? Lots of me attention, you know, here, look what I just ate. I've done all this stuff too. And that's okay sometimes if you think it's going to, you know, kind of help someone out, you know, show them something, teach them something, maybe entertain them. But, you know. To talk about humility and have that type of judgment is, I thought it was a joke. Hey, Troy, there's my brother.
Yeah, I was prepared to let the first one go, and then he escalated.
Right.
And he threatened us with banishment.
As if he had the power. On me? On our stream? No.
And I know people at YouTube, so all I got to do is just... drop the dime. Yeah. Make the
right, we don't need trolls like that.
I'm sure you'll get us in trouble.
I know. I try to think the best of people first. You know what I mean?
It's see, like, that's where I need to rub off on you a little bit.
I'm not great.
No, he didn't get that backwards. That's exactly what he meant.
There's like two people watching us on YouTube anyway.
He called his friend like, hey, I just got blocked. Get up. Yeah.
The army of trolls is marching.
It's so nice to not care what people think or get troubled by it. It's not that I don't care. I just don't let it trouble me.
I just block it from now and then down. You know what I mean? Just, all right, this is not.
Don't need that in my life. Don't need that drama, right?
Which enough is drama. Emoji? Looks like a pink Band-Aid. What is that? Or not emoji. Okay, is.
Like I said, first name only. No photo. Coward.
Oh, only 5 minutes?
I didn't know how long it was going to be.
What?
I thought he's only blocked
for 5 minutes.
Well, once he's unblocked, I'll block him again.
We'll see if he chimes back in. Tony, did you learn your lesson?
I'm guessing no.
We did to you what you threatened us with.
Oh my, here we go. 50 seconds, 5-0. What are people saying? What did Stacy just say?
There we go. Support.
Thank you, Stacy.
Cindy likes the block button too.
So maybe, well, freedom of speech. No, you don't have freedom of speech in a private channel. This is a marketing tool for the radio station.
Well, and our goal is to spread niceness.
Right.
Happiness.
But you can't go on like a marketing tool for a company. Oh, it sucks. No, go away. Then you know what? Find another one.
Well, it hasn't really added much to this guy. And also, maybe you think it sucks. And it's...
102.9 W4 Country and half of me. It's Thomas Rhett and Riley Green and the Breakfast with Bubba show in the morning. 7:56 is the time, and I thank you for listening along. We have Dr. Marty here, and I feel badly because I gave the shout out to Dean in New Mexico, Captain Dean Cott, serving us in the U.S. Air Force, and he missed it.
Oh, my heavens.
So I need to say good morning to him again.
Good morning, Dean.
Good morning. And be nice about it.
We wasted a good surprise already.
Well, whatever. There was an issue. He's in Clovis. I don't know what kind of internet's available in Clovis.
Maybe he should have got up and got on the stream in time. He can catch the replay.
You know, for a military man, he feels kind of late.
Right?
All right. We're talking about humility. None of which my co-hosts are showing today.
Nope.
Point number three, Marty.
Point number three, it earns you admiration and respect. Generally, I remember a couple, and I could tell you the story, but it bore you, of where I saw pure humility, and it really impressed me. And I was like, I want to be like that. Maybe because I was so far away from it that it was novel to me. But it's nice to see. Was it you?
Yeah.
Now you're being humble.
Okay, I just wondered. I like to be a good example, Marty.
Mm-hmm. You've impressed me at times.
What's point number four?
Four, strengthens connection with others. Like, think about how you respond to arrogant people or how people maybe responded to us when we behaved arrogantly. People don't like that. They like to be around people. They feel safer around people that are humble. They're less likely to judge us, you know, or reject us.
And I feel guilty about some of it. Like, we were at, when we were at Moonwinks, we had a listener named Amanda, and she came in, and I didn't know it because my back was to the door. And she sent me a message, and she's like, if you're going to be out and about, you should probably be more social. I've looked forward to meeting you forever. And it still haunts me. Like, she thought I was arrogant. I wasn't. I didn't see her. Mm-hmm. What was a twirling chair, Marty, where I just spin? All right. More with Dr. Marty coming up. We do have a Dean there as well.
Dean.
So he's joined the stream.
Hi, Dean.
But stay there. We'll chat with you in just a little bit. Right now, we got to check what's going on in the Brighton Ford Traffic Center. What do you got, Madison?
94 westbound. We are seeing some slower traffic. That starts around Michigan Avenue, and it's slow moving through 23 and then heavier again till State. A little heavier on US 12 right around 23. You're going to see some heavier traffic on Michigan Avenue through downtown Saline. It does look like there is an accident there. Just to the west of Ann Arbor Street, and it might be a little slower moving through that area. We have heavier traffic on Main Street through downtown Chelsea. And then 23 northbound, we're looking at some slower traffic starting just south of Michigan Avenue that continues up to 94. We have heavier traffic at the 14 and 23 interchange, and 23 southbound from 96 down to about Silver Lake Road, and heavier traffic on 96 eastbound just ahead of 23. And then it picks back up again through the construction, starting around Pleasant Valley, continuing all the way through Kent Lake. It is pretty slow moving through there. We also have some slower traffic through the construction on 275 north and southbound between Ford Road and 96. It's actually heavier on the interchange there, 275 and 96, and an accident on 14 between Sheldon and the interchange. If you have a tip for us, 734-623-1029. That's the latest from the only station specializing in your local traffic, 102.9 W4 Country.
This report is sponsored by NetSpend All Access Account. NetSpend All Access Account.
Tony's back. He do not like me.
Did you block him for good?
He's done.
Good.
He doesn't like me. What I do to you, Tony?
Eh,
That while I was doing traffic.
They need to let
pop up, but I couldn't read.
They need to let licensure know that it's all been a ruse.
All done.
Is that what you said? It's all a ruse.
But he said Marty's not a real doctor.
I'm not a physician. Called us all hypocrites, and Marty's not even a real doctor.
Mm-hmm.
He's just a troll.
Pray for this man. He's
nope.
He's
no, go report him.
No, why not? Well, I'll do both.
So Dean said it's only 6 a.m. So he's yelling back at you, Madison.
I was here on time.
He lives in New Mexico.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I got to see this weekend? He has a Tesla. I've never seen that on autopilot. It's pretty cool.
What do you mean? Oh, you? How did really? You see that?
Yeah. He owns one. Oh. And when he drove me to the airport, I was like, oh, I'll show you what autopilot does. It's pretty cool.
Hmm.
I want a car that just drives me to work.
Nope. It's not exactly how it works, you know.
Well, it seemed to.
You're also required to be, you know.
I know. You had to keep touching the wheel, yeah.
It won't just take you wherever you want
to
go.
I don't think that's going to be a great thing to have vehicles without drivers, human beings.
You don't. Like, that's the ultimate luxury. The car just pulls up in my driveway in the morning. I get in and it takes me to work.
Yeah, but I want a real person behind the wheel.
Oh, I want people to have jobs too.
Well,
no,
my car doesn't give me a job.
Why don't we just automate the whole morning show?
There's the technology for it,
right?
If you listen,
so just because there's the technology for it doesn't mean it should happen.
I think it's a dim view of human beings. Human beings aren't just, you know, machines, right? You can't replace them with a machine. They're more.
Do you know the ads though, like on social media, that I won't respond to? Like, no matter how intriguing the product, are the ones that use the fake voice, like that fake female voice.
There's a male one too.
They're just terrible.
I don't like them. It's annoying.
It's annoying. If you're a company and you can't pay for somebody to voice your commercial, you know, I don't want any. I don't want your product. Mm-hmm. All right, stand by. Keyword ready?
Yep.
Here we go.
Just before canceling service to continue remaining bill credits or credit stop and balance on required finance agreement is due. Apple TV Plus on us up to $4.99 value. In-flight Wi-Fi on select U.S. airlines were available. See T-Mobile.com for details.
Hey, good morning. We are 3 minutes after 8 o'clock, and I want to thank you for making us a part of your day. You found the Breakfast with Bubba show with Bubba and Madison Rowley.
Good morning. We'll see some showers today and breezy, and we are looking at highs in the mid-40s.
You're listening to WWWFM Ann Arbor. So very proud to be a Cumulus Media station. We've got a keyword worth $100 up to $25,000 right now.
You can text the national keyword FREE, F-R-E-E, to 95819 for your chance to win.
Get it in free. Please don't text and drive. You got about 57 minutes to get that in free to 95819. From the morning show that makes you feel good and your free money station. See, I almost said, unless you're driving a Tesla on automatic.
Peter Becker says, good morning. And it looks like, is that like a little mountain with a sunrise or something? The sun behind it? I thought it was like the barf face. I really hope not. That would, I don't want to look like the Jetsons. I really don't.
I'm sorry.
Here's my thing, though. If you can get widespread automation of vehicles, then you handle a lot of traffic problems.
Yeah.
Because whenever
or does it
you
just
have
create
those,
more problems?
No, you have those big freeway slowdowns because one person tapped their brakes and it ripples back. Mm-hmm. That doesn't happen anymore if everybody's automated.
Well, how will we practice our anger management skills?
Well, we won't pay attention to what's going on outside.
I think you're giving technology more credit than it deserves.
I mean,
it's not going to work.
It's
like
not
that.
Like Dean was crawling in the back seat. He was there with his hand like right below the wheel. Like he could have grabbed it at any point.
We have a problem with community anyway.
Doesn't this give you better community, Marty? Because then you can chat with the person in the car.
Chat while you're
driving. Well, I know we're in little boxes and, you know.
You could have a goddamn tea party while you're driving around.
You're right, Marty. What we need to perfect is mass transportation infrastructure.
Yeah, I think you're right. Where people can wait
together. We didn't get stuck with the automobile.
Mm-hmm.
when car manufacturers paid to have railways ripped up.
Yeah, and then people move away from each other more. Like, and I understand we can't go back to like the 1850s or whatever, but still, we should do things to restore community, like what you just said, Brian.
What, ride the train?
Look, you get to have conversations.
Improved mass transit, yeah.
Do you know my favorite plane rides are when I get to climb in a thing in a pod and close a door? I love those plane rides. You got to wait till you take off, though, to close the door. That's the only part that stinks.
You should just go in the bathroom and lock it.
Who just ran by?
I don't know.
They went very fast.
It was not a person I recognized either.
Hmm.
The new guy's here somewhere. I wonder if
maybe that was him.
Who is?
The new guy. What's his name?
Oh, I don't know. Scott?
You know what? I made that up last week. It might not actually be
Well,
Scott.
I keep wanting to say Chris. I know it's not Chris.
Well, because his last name's made up. Isn't it Vertical or something?
Way to make him feel welcome, team.
I made him feel
I've been nice to his face, nice, Marty. So. I said hello to him.
It's radio. What much more?
I was introduced as this is Madison. She's on the other station, so she's the enemy.
What?
I was literally introduced that way.
This is Lord of the Flies.
Really joking, but.
Whatever.
So if his name's not Scott, I'm not really worried about it right now.
Did you hear that one? Question mark.
Did you hear that one?
He's texting Dean.
Oh.
Instead of asking Dean if you're still there. Uh-huh. Did you hear?
Well,
us
I don't know that
you?
He's on here.
He just commented.
He's commenting.
But he could have listened on the app, but he hasn't commented.
Like telepathic skills or something, or he may have some mystical way of viewing this. Let's bring Tony back. Get this party going again.
I only know how to block. I don't know how to unblock.
Is there an unblock and re-invite button?
But don't you feel badly for
oh, Dean is like still that? Here.
Do you not feel like a little sympathy for people like that? Because you must be miserable to get upset over this. You imagine if there's a real conflict in his life. He won't be able to manage it.
He should deal with that. Mm. And stop trolling on us. Don't spread more conflict because you have conflict in your life.
I will admit, Marty, I'm having a hard time in the moment having compassion for Tony.
Mm-hmm.
It's hard to...
Like, I feel bad if he's really having a bad day, but don't go spread bad to other people.
Well, Brian, you guys are right. I agree with you. Like, my compassion ends when you start hurting other people, but that doesn't bother me. So, didn't hurt me at all.
I'm really kind of indifferent on Tony. He's gone.
It's over now.
I won't remember Tony 10 minutes from now.
Tony?
See, that's the opposite. Who said that's the opposite of love? Was it Hannah Arendt or someone? It's not hate. Yeah. The opposite.
Yeah. Hate's not the opposite of love. Indifference.
Yeah. I don't agree with that, but I get the point. Do you agree with that? I think hate's the opposite of love, but.
I don't know, because with hate, you still have like passion.
Sometimes, yeah. I think sometimes what people describe as hate is still passion.
Yes, agreed. Yeah, the relationship matters. You're just not being the way I want you to be.
Yeah,
but I mean true hatred, because hate destroys, love creates, right?
Yep. Yeah,
that's what I'm all about, Marty.
Love. You should be a hippie.
Should I?
Yeah, I think that'd be good.
Stop bathing with drawing your hair.
Yeah.
All the things we expect from Bubba.
I think politically I'd have to readjust a little bit too.
I can't imagine you listening to a lot of like Grateful Dead. Can't see you being big on jam bands.
Yeah. Fish.
Yeah.
I went to a Fish show once.
Did you?
It was fun.
Okay. Yeah. People like the culture. It's kind of a dead culture, right? Grateful Dead mm-hmm. culture.
Yeah. Yeah. I didn't really know what to expect. It's not super my thing, but I went with friends and I had a really good time.
But it was the people, right? Not the band.
And everybody was cool. Mm. I didn't say anything about that.
I know. You didn't have to. It's a Fish concert.
Stand by quickly.
Most people are good. I believe most people are good.
102.9 W4 Country, Luke Bryan. I believe some people are good.
No, that's you. That's what you believe. Luke believes most people are good.
I'm telling you what I believe.
You can't change the lyrics.
It was two separate thoughts. It was Luke Bryan, and then I believe some people are good.
Sure.
Let's go way back right now with the Chicks. Goodbye, Earl.
Marianne and Wanda were the best.
You're playing good music today. You play some Brooks and Dunn.
You always play good music.
So who believes that most people are good?
Good music about murdering people.
Madison, Bryan, and Bubba. What do you believe? Do you believe that most people are good?
I believe most people want to be good. Think that they're good.
Yep.
Okay. That's fair.
I don't believe most people act good all the time.
That's
even if they think they are.
Yeah, people have the desire or like the aspiration to be good, mm-hmm. but it's easily challenged.
That's a great way of putting it, I think. But because of that, that's why I think all of this conflict, that's part of why I wanted to do this topic. It's going to heat up because of the political environment.
And what do we know about good intentions?
Road to...
I don't know if most people have good intentions, Cindy.
Most. I get to sit with people and I really get to know them. And all of these things that people are saying about these different groups aren't true. Most people are just trying to find a way to have a happy life. They're not really concerned with,
So that's I've heard it before. The majority of people are not against you. They're just for themselves.
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay.
Now there are some sadists out there.
Mm-hmm, but there's a small percentage. We study those psychopaths and all that.
Yeah. There are some people who derive pleasure from hurting other people. But mm-hmm. for the most part, we're just trying to get what we want.
Yeah, but those people that you mentioned that will hurt each other or other people, they often rise to power, right? And so then they have a lot of influence, and then it seems like everybody's like that, you know?
Yeah, we've made positions of leadership appealing to narcissists.
Yes, yes, yeah, that's been studied.
It's supposed to be a civil service. People shouldn't want to be president.
No, why?
Oh, I would never want to be president.
Well, but that's the thing. It appeals to the wrong sort of person.
Because it looks like power.
I think that looks like the worst job in the world. The only cool thing about it is Air Force One. But you know what? Singapore Airlines Suites is pretty nice. I can't afford that, but you know.
You also can't tell them where and when you want to go.
I don't know. When you're getting 21 grand round trip, maybe you can. Mm. You can tell them what you want to eat.
Okay.
Now that's real power.
It's the same thing.
They have the book the cook service.
Do you use beard oil, Welch?
I did at one point. I don't.
Why? I just got some.
I'm okay.
Feel like my complexion is oily enough.
It is.
You know what? I did get a zit. Maybe it's a beard oil.
He's so hot, ladies.
I have very oily skin. I don't want to put beard oil on my face too. Because you know what? I really don't get any like blemishes or anything where my beard comes in.
Yeah. You got a nice mustache.
Thank you.
That's actually why I can't grow anything because I break out like a seventh grader.
Oh. Ingrown?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Is that what the oil is for, to keep you from breaking out?
No. It's supposed to help the beard come in thicker and more luxurious.
Maybe you should use it.
and it dampens it down a little bit so it doesn't get all gnarly, you know, like some parts sticking up.
I still have some. I'll start using it again if you want me to.
Smells funny.
Dean texted me and he said that the first time he went through pre-check, he took off his shoes. The guy behind him yelled at him, said, "Dude, stop, put your shoes back on. You're making us all look
bad." They tell you, listen to the people who are running the whole area because they tell you what to and to not do. There are signs that are posted.
102.9 W4 Country. And goodbye, Earl. It's 8:14. And one of the earliest songs in country music about murder.
It's a whole subgenre of country.
It is.
We got a few right now that are in our top 20 songs.
About country death songs. That's a thing. You're right, Welch.
This thing. We've got Bubba and Madison in the morning.
Good morning.
A keyword is in play right now.
Text free, FREE, to 95819 for your chance to win.
We have Welch with the forecast.
Highs only in the mid-40s with some rain showers today.
Do we get warmer anytime in the near future?
Yeah, we're looking at highs around 60 on Friday.
Okay.
Pretty sunny.
I'll take it. I might go to Mexico this weekend. I haven't decided.
Old Mexico?
Old Mexico. This is old Mexico. Merida.
All right.
So we'll figure that out. We have Dr. Marty here. Cool. We're talking about being humble and the benefits of that. What's point number five, Marty?
Point number five, humility is associated with positive emotions, including happiness and a sense of well-being, peace.
And do you have a bonus for us?
I have a bonus for us. Humility strengthens connections between spirituality, religion, and well-being. Seems to be a common thread between these. So if you have a person like a spiritual guide or teacher and they're not showing you humility, beware of that, because truly spiritual people who are following the path. I mean, think about the ascetics, for instance. You know, that's a good model to look at that.
For those who don't know, Marty, would you explain what the ascetics are? I mean, that made sense to me, but
monks, nuns, you know, people that have just renounced much of the world to focus on spirituality and service to other people.
All right.
Look at your face. I wish everyone could see your face.
A very humble moment, Marty. I understand it, but explain it to everyone else.
What?
We needed him to explain it to you.
I understand it. I understand it.
Oh, okay. I didn't know what he meant by that. So I played the lack of humility.
I'm amazed how this topic has caused you to fight, the three of you.
I understood what you said, because, you know, like when I've gone to church, I've gone to the Russian Orthodox Church, which is that's like a very humble place.
Yeah, I agree.
And you compare that with like some, like, you know, I don't know, like I have nothing against Joel Osteen. I think he's a great motivational speaker, but I mean, you compare it to that, it's not even apples and oranges. It's you know, apples and Goodyear tires. I mean, it's not even the same thing.
All terrain Goodyear tires.
Absolutely. Fancy Goodyear tires. All right. That's going to do it for the Monday Morning Jumpstart for today. Have a great week, Marty.
Thank you very much.
I will see you tomorrow. Dr. Martin Fletcher here every single Monday morning with your Monday Morning Jumpstart. We want everyone to know that, hey, you know what? We need to normalize all this and start talking about these things. And you can join him at drmartinfletcher.com if you have any more questions. Time right now is 8:18. Let's get you on the road with a check from the Brighton Ford Traffic Center. What do you got?
Things are starting to look a little better, actually. 94 westbound, we're still seeing some slowdowns, though, starting just past Michigan Avenue, continuing through 23, and then heavier still state. Just a little heavier on US 12, right around 23. It looks like the mess downtown.